In this video, we are discussing about boats and stream, which is the further part of the chapter time and distance. Already we understood that when we are talking about trains, it is the independent motion of two bodies. Now when we are talking about boats and stream, it is the dependent motion. Now when I am saying dependent motion, that means that the speed of boat will also depend on the speed of stream. Because if you see on the higher altitudes, the river flows at a higher rate, then the speed of boat is high. And when it comes to the plain area, where the speed of stream is low, then the speed of boat is also low. And that also depends whether the boat is going in the upward direction or the boat is going in the downward direction. So where we are discussing about the four different kind of speed, one is SB. The speed of boat or man in still water. This is when we talk about still water, we are talking about something like swimming pool. Means whether when the person is actually swimming in a swimming pool, or when a boat is going in a swimming pool, or a place where there is still water, then it is only the speed of boat or man which matters. The second is SS, that is the speed of stream. When we talk about speed of stream, it can be written as current, it can be written as water, it can be written as river. The speed of river or speed of current or speed of water. This is actually the speed of the flow of water. This is basically we can also say the flow of water. Now here we know the water is flowing, so the speed of the flow of water is known as SS. Third is speed downstream. Now this is understood, if the river is definitely moving in the downstream, when the boat is also running in the lower portion or in the towards the flow of water, then the speed of boat will be high. While if the boat is going in the upward direction or against the direction of the flow of water, then the speed of upstream will be low. So here we can say the speed of downstream is equal to speed of boat plus speed of stream, or the speed of upstream is equal to speed of boat minus speed of stream. So these are basically the two basic formula which are applicable to this chapter. Now when in the first video also we discussed that the speed can be given in two different formats. One is they can directly give you that the speed of boat in still water is 5 km per hour. To this they can also write the speed of boat. Instead of a speed, they will use the term distance and time. They will say that a boat goes 10 km in 2 hours in still water. If I am saying the boat goes 10 kilometers in 2 hours in still water, that actually means that in 1 hour it will go 5 kilometers, or the speed is 5 kilometers per hour. So every speed, whether it is the speed of boat, stream, downstream or upstream, can be written in the context of distance and time. For example, I can say the distance a boat travels with the stream is 20 kilometers in 4 hours. So this actually means that the speed downstream is equals to 20 upon 4. 20 is the distance and 4 is the number of hours, is equals to 5 kilometers per hour. So this is also basically the speed is given, but in the context of distance and time, which we can divide and further come to speed. So basically there are these four things: the speed of boat in still water, speed of stream, speed downstream and speed upstream. If we subtract these two, or if we add these two, we get to two more formula. Suppose we are adding these two, it becomes 2SB. This can be cancelled out by this, SB plus SR. Or speed of boat is equal to SD plus SR divided by 2. Now to this we can also say the average of speed downstream and the speed upstream can be written as the speed of boat, because in downstream the speed of stream is added In upstream, the speed of stream is subtracted. So if in case we add these two and divide it by two, it will give you the speed of boat. Why? If we subtract these two equations, we will get 2SS as SD minus SR. And the value of SS will become SD minus SR divided by 2. So this is another, you can say, the fourth formula which we can get. This is the third one. Now these are basically the four formulas which are useful in this chapter. On the other hand, we can say that there are four different type of speeds which are possible. That is speed of boat, speed of steam, speed downstream and speed upstream. And out of these four, any two of the things are given in our question and the remaining two we have to find out. There is a possibility that speed of boat and speed of steam are given and the remaining two things we have to find out. Suppose we say the speed of boat is 10 km per hour and speed of steam is 2 km per hour. So we may have to find out the speed of downstream. Now we understand the speed of boat is 2 and the speed of steam is 2 and speed of boat is 10. So definitely the downstream will be 12 because we have to add these two numbers. And the upstream will come out to be 8 because we have to subtract these two numbers according to these two formulas. And we also know that the downstream is greater than the value of upstream. There is a possibility speed of boat and speed of downstream is given. Suppose the speed of boat is given as 8 and speed of downstream is given as 10. And we have to find out the value of upstream as well as the stream. So the value of stream will come out to be 2 because adding these two will get this and subtracting these two will get this. So here it will come out to be 6. So either these two values are given, the remaining two you have to find out. These two values are given and the remaining two we have to find out. It is also possible that the speed of boat is given, that is 12. And speed of upstream, this must be lower than the speed of boat, is given, that is 9. So if it is 12 and this is 9, we can directly find out the speed of stream, that will come out to be 3. And if the speed of steam is 3 and speed of boat is 12, then we can add them and this comes out to be 15. So with this, either this is given or this is given or this is given. This is the case when the speed of boat is given. There may be a possibility that this and this value are given and we have to find out the remaining two. For example, the speed of steam is given as 2 and speed of downstream is given as 8. Now, downstream is 8 and stream is 2. Definitely the speed of boat comes out to be 6. This is unknown. We can apply this to this formula where downstream is given, where speed of stream is given. So 8 minus 2 comes out to be 6. And if we have to find out the speed of upstream, it comes out to be 4 because it is boat minus stream. So from these two formulas, we can apply this. If in case it is given and this is given, then the speed of stream and upstream is given, we can apply in this. Stream is given and upstream is given. If we go to this side, it will be added. So here comes out to be 8 as the speed of boat. And if we add these two, it comes out to be 11. This is the speed of downstream. So from this, this is given, this is given, this is given. With this, and this is given. The last can be when these two values are given to us, definitely the speed of downstream is greater than the speed of upstream. We know these two values are given. The average of these two numbers should be the speed of boat. 15 and 11, the average or the middle number to these two numbers, that is 13, will come out to the speed of boat. And if we add or subtract this, the 2 will be the speed of steam. So these two values are unknown. So there can be basically 6 different questions which are possible where any of the two values are given and the remaining two values we have to find out, which we can all calculate from these four formulas. So in the end we can say that these are the four terms which are used in this chapter. These are the four formulas which are there. So if in case the speed of boat, speed of stream, these are known and we have to find out the speed of downstream. Now we have to look at that these three values are given in which formula. So B, S and D, this is given in the first formula. So the first formula is applicable in this kind of question. Suppose instead of SD, S up we have to find out, and these two values are given. So definitely the second formula is very much applicable and we can find out the value of S up. If in case SD and S up is given as in the last case, and we have to find out the value of SB or we have to find out the value of SS, then definitely finding the value of SB, the third formula has to be understood, that the speed of boat is equals to the speed downstream, that is 15 in this case. So it is 15 plus the speed upstream, that is 11, divided by 2, and there comes the value 13. If in case we have to find out the value of SS, when these two values are given, then we have to subtract the 2 and divide by 2. So it is 15 minus 11 divided by 2. If we calculate, it comes out to be the value 2. So if we know any two values and we have to calculate the third value, we have to first of all look at which two values are given and which value we have to find out. After that, we have to see that which formula is suitable for this particular question, and then to apply and solve.